middle of the night with a few of her best men.
Her best men? But she didn't bring you?
No. I'd been drinking a lot. You know, maybe she thought that... damn, I don't know. I couldn't hack it. Search parties found their bodies the next day and the corpses of some Shadow Carja cowards. It was an ambush. The Shadow Carja are animals. They beat her so bad we can't even show her face before burial.
I'm so sorry, Erend.
Yeah, well, when I find the soldiers who did this, they'll be sorry too.
You don't have any idea why she left in the middle of the night?
No. But it must have been urgent. A message, a report of some new Shadow Carja threat, I don't know.
Why would the Shadow Carja do this?
Because they hate us, and Ursa most of all. She teamed up with Avad to kick their asses out of Meridian. They've been licking their wounds for 2 years, but they finally found a way to get back at her.
All right. Show me where Ursa fell, and I'll do what I can to help.
Come on, follow me.
Why would Ursa come all the way out here?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense.
Is this Shadow Carja territory?
No. They broke the ceasefire as soon as they set foot in the cleft. There. All right, this is it, where the ambush happened. Our soldiers have been over it, but maybe that fancy artifact of yours can find a clue or something. Please. I need to find the bastards that did this.
These look like drag marks. Did someone move a body through here?
What do you see there?
This stain forms a line. As if blood dripped off the edge of something. Like a cart. See? Cart tracks. I think someone moved the bodies here, then scattered them across the field.
Wait. Are you saying the dead found here were killed somewhere else? But why would the Shadow Carja do that?
At this point, I'm not taking it for granted that the Shadow Carja are responsible.
Of course they were.
Well, let's follow these tracks and find out. Saving these for the trail.
I get why they wanted to. Why fake an ambush?
There's more to this. And we're gonna figure it out. Forget about traveling light.
These guys aren't Shadow Carja. They're from my tribe, the Oseram.
Is this how your people usually greet each other?
Huh?
I think it's calling in machines. Get ready.
Thank you.
switch weapons.
Asaram, not Shadow Carja. Looks like I was wrong about everything, as usual. Please, use that second sight of yours. I have to know what really happened.
I'm on it. What are those leather straps? Those rocks, they're shattered. These look like Vanguard weapons. Looks like you could mount some equipment on that thing. Blood. straps, cut with a knife, and a rock with blood on it.
Please, use that second sight of yours. I have to know what really happened.
There, by the tripod, a used power cell. Something hit these stones. Something I've never seen before. There's no blood on them. Ursa's men didn't fight back.
This is Ursa's helmet. I thought she died in the field below, but must have been here. All this trickery. For what? Feels like it's just to torture me.
I have a theory. But it takes a little imagination.
So far, your theories are better than other people's facts.
All right. I think the Oseram ambushed Ursa and her men with a new weapon. They mounted it on that tripod up there. It fires waves of force, maybe sound. Looks like it cracked the stone there. I think it paralyzes people instead of killing them. It dropped the vanguard right there. No blood on their weapons. No fight.
But why paralyze them if you're only gonna move them and gut them?
They were trying to hide something. Look here, a bloody rock.
That they used to smash Ursa's face in.
Or someone else's. These leather straps have been cut, as if they took the armor off someone.
That can't be. Her body is lying in state in Meridian. I saw it.
You said she was unrecognizable. Maybe they switched another body into her armor, someone around the same size, and mutilated it enough so it could have been anyone, even Ursa. Go back to Meridian. Take another look at that body. If it's really Ursa, of course I'm wrong. But if I'm right,
Then my sister could be alive. I'm going. Meet me back there when you can.
A lot of people died here. A massacre.
Of it. Won't find better wear.
the finest goods here. See for yourself.
Your shard, just a look.
Thank you.
Only the finest goods here.
Check out these wares. Come take a look. I'll give you a good price.
Watch out for the Oseram merchants. They'll soon cheat you as look at you. Some Oseram girl looks like this.
No one goes into the palace without an invitation.
Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Marad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
What do you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without further delay. Follow me, please.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you, the machine tamer with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
First the Oseram gets special treatment, and now outlanders from the Savage East? What possible interest could the Sun King have in her?
Passed by some outlander woman? Unacceptable. I've been here for 2 hours, and this Nord goes to the front of the line.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Aloy of the Nora. She who sees the unseen. Welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ursa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing a scar below her right knee. I gave it to Ursa when we were kids, fighting over a toy sword.
If the body is not Ursa's, then we must assume she is still alive. And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ursa has an enemy among the Oseram. A warlord named Dervon.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Oseram had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ursa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate. He'll be waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Oseram, but I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well. Erend, Murat, let me discuss it with her privately. I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ursa means a lot to you.
Without her Oseram vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ursa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken. He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Oseram. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty. He captured Dervahl's wife and daughter and sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
So, why would Dervahl go to so much trouble to kidnap Ursa?
He felt she betrayed him. She fought by his side until she realized he planned to raise Meridian and butcher its people. Then she came to me. Together, we stopped him and liberated the city from my father. Dervahl has spent every moment since trying to get revenge. Mostly on the other Oseram who fought with us. He made so many powerful enemies, I thought we'd seen the last of him. I was wrong.
I'd like to ask you something about the Sundom and its politics.
By all means.
They call you a sun god who killed his own father in order to unite the tribes in harmony. Is any of it true?
They say you can see the invisible, split an arrow at 50 paces, and tame machines at a glance. How much of that is true?
It's not too far off.
Well, I would like to unite the tribes in harmony, but you saw how many courtiers I have to deal with first. Maybe next week.
Quite a place you've got here. You can almost see the little people below the mesa.
You don't approve? Well, I have a secret for you. Neither do I. But we must be patient. Change won't come in a single sunrise.
But will it happen at all, while men live in palaces?
It might. Eventually. If people like you help me bring it about.
Your politics seem very complicated. The Oseram are friends, but enemies too?
I couldn't have liberated Meridian without the help of Ursa and her Oseram freebooters. Many of them have settled here. But the Ealdermen of the Oseram clans and the Claim have become jealous of their success. So have many Karja nobles. It's a volatile situation, especially given the fact that my father raided the Oseram for years. Ursa helps keep the peace, promising a future based on mutual gain. But some, like Dervahl, will never let go of their venom.
What can you tell me about the Shadow Karja? What do they have to do with Ursa?
They are remnants of my father's regime, holding out at the fortress of Sunfall to the west. Like him, they care only for domination, and seek to draw upon the power of the sun by spilling blood in its name. Since Ursa helped me take this city from them, they were perfect scapegoats. Dervahl knew this, of course, and planned it well.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ersa.
Who says that?
Well, Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions.
Waste of time. Show was better last week.
Sunlight they're passing. Thank you, Nora.
For an old remedy.